everyone, thank you all so much for stopping by the channel today and welcome back to this brand new video. Now in today's video I'm going to be showing you a female outfit. This is basically a full pink outfit using the two console glitch. And this has been requested a lot. I never actually did two console female outfits, so today it will be the very first outfit tutorial. So this outfit has pink joggers, we have pink adversary shoes and gloves, we have also a pink adversary cat suit, white bow tie, white racing suit belt, and an adversary cap, but that is just like accessories. So I'm going to show you how to build the full outfits, so let's get straight started. Now as always, you need to have a second console or a trustworthy friend who can help you out, logged into your account into story mode. And he or she should basically be suspended, but GTA will be loaded up. Now as well, Netcut needs to be downloaded. That link will also be in the description box down below. And since I am not including the transfer or the two console glitch in this video, I will be leaving a helpful tutorial for you all as well in the description box down below, so you know exactly how the two console method works. So now that you have everything all set up to build your outfits, let's get straight started. Now first things first, you need to have a pair of joggers. I am just using this one from the CEO, and you're gonna apply the sand t-shirt on top. Now make sure that you have no other accessories applied, and then you can simply save this on outfit slot number 20. Now if you have that saved, you now want to grab yourself the green racing suit. You're going to save that on slot number 1. And then on slot number 2, you need this outfit where I made a separate tutorial on. So that link will also be in the description box down below, the C2 keep outfits. Now before you save this, make sure that you apply the sand cargo pants and that you put on the white two-tone backside skate shoes. And then you can save this on outfit slot number 2. Now you can start off with the first buff, so you can simply do this using the C1 and C2 outfits. Do this using the classic shoot bag, or the Israel shoot bag. And like I said before, if you don't know how two console glitch works, a helpful tutorial will be in the description box down below. Now if you did that correctly, this is what you should load in with. It's a very weird mix between the racing suit and the jacket. Now we're going to be merging it together with the sand t-shirt. So for that you want to go over to the Crooked Cop mission. You can either host it or join it from somebody else, but you want to make sure as always that cloning has been set over to player owned. Now if the job is fully loaded up, you will be at the screen right here. Each time we're just going to click once to the left, then back once to the right, and then this is what you should be getting. Now if you have it all set up like this, you will spawn into the job as well with the racing suit shoes. So you're now going to be putting on a rebreather or an earpiece to save this, and then you can quit the job however you want it. Now once you are back, this will basically be your new C1 outfit, so you can simply resave this on a slot number 1. Now we're going to be changing the joggers into pink, we're going to be changing the racing suit shoes as well into pink, and we're going to be putting on the racing suit gloves. But first of all, we're putting on the racing suit belt because it is the different color that we want. So for that, you're going into utility vest and you're putting on the peach camo plate carrier, and then I suggest you to just simply save this on slot number 1. Now once saved, you're going to be putting on a heist coverall with a gas mask as always, and you're flying over to the telescope at the beach. Now as soon as you have arrived, you're going to be doing the telescope glitch by running past it. Simply press right on the D-pad, and as soon as you are glitched out, you are applying the outfit that we have just saved. Now once applied, you should see that the gas mask should go over just like that. And then you can resave it on the same outfit slot. Now for the next step, we're going to be hitting kill ourselves, and once we have respawned, we're just reapplying the outfits. So now you are fully ready to do the Titan belt merch. So as the name already says it, we're going to be starting up Titan of a job for the next step. And if you do that correctly, you should load in without the body armor. Now you're going to be making your way over to the emanation inside of this mission, and you're going to be resaving it again on the same outfit slot. Now before quitting the job, make sure that you put on the white racing suit, and then you can simply find a new session. Now in this new session, you again want to make your way over to that same Crooked Cop mission so we can merge the racing suit belt on. But this time on the outfit selection screen, we're not scrolling once to the left, no, we're only scrolling once to the right to put the racing belt on, and this is what it should look like. So again, you can simply save this using your rebreather or earpiece, and then you can quit the mission. Now for the next step, like I said before, we're changing the colors of the items and we're going to be adding the racing suit gloves. So make sure that you resave this again on slot number one. Now for slot number two, you want to go over to the pants section first. From here, you want to go into the cargo pants and you're putting on these gray digital cargos. Now for shoes, you want to go into the rubberized boots and you're putting on these white trail boots. And for gloves, you're putting on the gray digital tactical gloves, which is the same component as for the male to merge the racing suit gloves. Now once you have it set up like this, you're going to be saving this on outfit slot number 2. And then for the merge, it is pretty easy. You're just grabbing the black biker suit and saving that on slot number 20. So now you can redo the two console glitch using your new C1 and C2 outfits. So simply do that again, and if you have done it correctly, you can easily check it because your joggers have turned into pink as well as your racing suit shoes. So all that's left to do for us is to merge on the gloves using the same Crooked Cop mission, same settings. So this time we're going to be doing it again, so just once to the left, then back once to the right. And then your gloves should pop on just like that. So again, hit ready to play, save this and quit the mission. So make sure to resave this again on slot number 1. And for the next step, we're going to be putting on the white bow tie and we're changing these gloves into the pink adversary color. Now for that, you want to apply the black desert scarf. And then for the gloves, you're putting on the splinter tactical gloves, and then you can save that on slot number 2. Now for the merge, it is pretty easy. You just want to put on any suit jacket or fitted suit jackets. And for me, I always go with the boating blazers. And then you can simply apply your white bow tie and save that on slot number 20. I know we're going quickly. If you think that I'm going too quick, and you can just pause the video and just do the steps for yourself. It doesn't have to be as quickly as I am going, because I know I'm like a fast train going right now. So once you have that saved on slot number 20, you can just do the two console glitch again and do this using your new C1 and C2. I completely forgot to mention the parachute bag, but you want to use the classic parachute bag, as well as for the previous above, you also wanted to use the classic parachute bag, which was also shown in the video. So if done correctly, your gloves of course have changed into pink, just like you can see right here. And then again in Crooked Cop, we're merging on the bow tie by going once to the left, then back once to the right. So after saving this, our C1 is completely done. We're almost done with this outfit. So all that's left to do is save it and quit the mission. Now you're going to be saving this as your new C1 outfit, and then I'm going to be showing you the C2 outfit as well, because after this we need to do two more baths to finish this outfit off. So save this on slot number 1, and then for slot number 2 you want to grab the outfit from the beginning again, which was the C2 keep outfit. Now you want to go into the pants and you're going to be putting on the corresponding items for the joggers and shoes and gloves. So that will be the same items that we also used in the beginning. So those will be the gray digital cargo jogger or cargo pants and also the gray digital gloves. And then for shoes, you're putting on the white trail boots as well. And then you can save this as your new C2 outfit. Now for the merch, which we do not have, it will be the adversary catsuit. Now, because we do not have that already, we first of all need to create it, and then afterwards we can merge it. So leave your slot 1 and 2 as it is, and for the next step, you're going to be putting on a catsuit. Now, I haven't purchased one yet, so I'm just going for the cheapest one that I'm seeing right here. Doesn't matter which one you pick. And you're going to be saving that at the bottom of your outfit list. So what I did is I just called this top number 2 and I saved it on slot number 19. Now to change this top into pink, you want to go into the designer sports jackets and you're putting on the stylized Guffy puffer, and then you're going to be saving that right above your catsuit. So I just called this one a top number 1, of course. Now you're first of all going to be doing the 2 console glitch using these 2 outfits that you're having right here. And to do this using the Israel shoe bag. If done correctly, you will load in with the pink catsuit. It will be like a very funny looking outfit like this. But we only need to pay attention to the top, of course. So you're going to be saving this on a slot number 20 and you can delete the other slots. Now we have one more Beth left to go, so once you have this saved as your merch, you can now do the 2 console glitch using the original C1 and C2, again using the Israel shoe bag. After doing that, this is what you should load in with, so it basically will be the full C1 outfit, but the t-shirt has changed into this smart jacket, and if you have that, you know that you did it correctly. So you can now make your way over to Cricut Cup one last time to do the final merch. So again, we're going once to the left, then back once to the right. And boom, there is your female 2 console outfit, looking all fresh and ready it up. So don't forget to save it, of course, hit ready to play and put on your earpiece. And then it is time for you to finish off your outfit however that you want it. So for me, I went and grabbed myself the pink duffel bag from the Husky job. I also glitched the pink forwards cap and I just put on a gator mask. Now, if you're going to be doing it with the gator mask as well, you can simply transfer the hat over using the car method and it will stick. Your gator mask will stick, it will not spawn off. Then you can put on your duffel bag and that is your finished look. So I hope you guys enjoyed this first female Beth outfit tutorial. Please leave a thumbs up if this worked. Subscribe to the channel and then I hope to see you back in the next video, of course. Bye guys!